picnic lunch, but no clouds in this room whatsoever. So good afternoon. It truly is my honor to be with all of you today. My name is Thomas Farley, and it's my privilege to be your host for this occasion in celebration of Women of Inspiration. As a commentator and speaker on the topic of modern manners, I give a lot of thought to where we are today as a culture and whether good etiquette is on the decline. And by a show of hands, how many of you would say that etiquette is worse today than ever? Okay, see a lot of hands. How about anyone think it's about the same as it's always been? Okay, small handful. Anyone think it's better? Okay, a couple. Yeah. Well, the fact is, we've entered an age where technology easily enables and yet so quickly disables human connection. We shop in stores with self-checkout stations. We swipe left on images of dating prospects who don't interest us. We pop in our headphones at the gym and on the train to drown out the world. Even at dinner with friends and family, the cell phones universally hit the table long before the food ever does. And don't even get me started on the vitriol that is social media. Way before Facebook or Twitter or iPhones, one of my predecessors in the realm of etiquette and manners, and quite likely the most famous etiquette expert of all time, Emily Post, once said, "Manners are a sensitive awareness of the feelings of others. If you have that awareness, you have good manners, no matter what fork you use." So don't worry, I won't be watching you to see what fork you're using today. I know the folks at my table have been petrified. All you all get an A+. Manners, etiquette, human interaction, and the quality of those interactions have a ripple effect on us all. I'm a big advocate for treating others not as you wish to treat them, nor as how you wish to be treated, but really focusing on how they wish to be treated. Practicing good manners means embracing this philosophy wholeheartedly. In doing so, we exit the careless zone and enter the consideration zone. This way of treating people was instilled in me early on by my parents. They are truly givers with a passion for philanthropy. Throughout my childhood and still to this day, they have volunteered at soup kitchens, food pantries, and retirement homes. That example inspired me to volunteer by building homes in Mexico, school libraries in Costa Rica, and by serving meals to the homeless on the streets of New York City. Walking a mile in other people's shoes and embracing the ripple effects of considerate actions and interactions, that's how we deliver purpose. And by the way, I love the thought of delivering 3 million pairs of socks, because I'm so often asked in the media about how to rightfully ask your guests to remove their shoes before they enter their home. So it all starts with having the right pair of socks on as a guest. And delivering good is certainly helping that happen. So when Rita Polidori O'Brien, who some of you may know, she's my longtime friend and college classmate, introduced me to delivering good last fall, I knew I had to learn more. Rita is a true delivering good ambassador. And the press event, which was sponsored by her company, United Legwear, focused on how the fashion and retail community are able to come together to the rescue in the aftermath of natural disasters. The concept and the mission of delivering good, so simple and yet so vital, was inspiring to me. Since that time, I've visited and volunteered at one of Delivering Good's local community partners, Children of Promise in Bedford-Stuyvesant. For those of you who don't know it, Children of Promise is a wonderful organization that provides after-school programming, support, and mentorship for children of incarcerated parents. During that visit, I sat down with a group of their teenage participants, and we spoke about the value of bringing their best selves to every interaction. We talked about the value of eye contact, the positive message conveyed by a firm handshake, and the importance of putting people over pixels. These young men and women instantly and intrinsically embraced the value and importance of quality human interaction. And they practiced skills that will benefit them throughout their personal and their professional lives. In fact, some of them are already experienced public speakers, including making remarks at delivering good events. In my own keynotes and in my communication strategy workshops around the country, I spend a lot of time reminding adults in corporate America to be more like these kids. I've been truly inspired by the work of Delivering Good and how your support helps alleviate the effects of poverty and other challenges faced by the children and adults who receive these product donations. We all have a role to play, and I thank you so much all for the role that you are playing and have allowed me to play today.